Admiral Anderson asks if anyone made it into the superstructure.
Negative. Our entire force was decimated. We need to regroup. Fall back to the buildings.
All forces, retreat! Pull back! Pull back!
Where's our fire support? We need reinforcements on the...
There are now a dozen Reapers blocking their path. It appears that their plan has failed. Admiral Hackett is hearing reports that the Reapers have broken their lines. Sword fleet is in pieces. This looks like the end. He announces that it's been an honor serving with so many brave men and women, but he will go down fighting.
This is Commander Shepard. I'm in the superstructure. Activating the crucible now.
Reaper ground forces are converging on your location. We're fighting our way to you. Hold on, Commander. Hold on. Hammer squads, go, go, go!
It's now or never, Admiral.
Acknowledge. All ships, this is Admiral Hackett. The Crucible is on the move. I repeat, the Crucible is on the move. Protect it at all costs. We've got to give Hammer more time.
Overloading the Crucible will destroy this facility, Shepard. You will not survive.
I didn't know that. Thanks. The Crucible facility will detonate after the discharge.
No one can hear you.
Get clear from the blast. I repeat, get clear from the Crucible. Can anyone hear me?
We read you, Shepard. We are backing off. What about you? Can you get out? Do you need transport? Shepard! Shepard!
But Shepard can't hear her. Harbinger's jamming the signal. Reapers themselves are firing on the Crucible in a desperate attempt to stop her. Reaper husks are now in the corridor, dashing towards Shepard.
Shepard, you are throwing everything away only to die alone.
Commander, nothing's happening. The Crucible's not firing. It's gotta be something on your end. Commander! Commander Shepard!
Shepard, you okay?
Thank you.
The Reapers crumble to their knees. Without the Overmind to guide them, the indoctrinated minions fall to the ground as well. The victory fleet is cheering. The war is over. The news quickly reaches Rannoch, Tuchanka, and the Citadel. Every race expresses their jubilation in their own unique ways. Krogan roared, Asari danced. Other races embraced each other in joy and tears. The Geth are not sure how to express their newfound emotions. We get a glimpse of Jack and Grunt rejoicing with their respective squads. Anderson takes everything in and says,
You did good, child. I'm proud of you.
Now the Reaper fragments are plummeting into the atmosphere and crushing into the ocean. And finally we see Shepard's squad on the hill. They are the only ones not celebrating. Their commander, their friend, is gone. Liara's in tears. Edie tries to comfort her. Garrus looks at all the races in the valley below and wonders if Shepard's sacrifice will really bring peace and for how long. Rex promises that as long as he is alive, the Krogan will not cause trouble. Slowly, Caden takes out an old photo of the commander and says she would have loved to see this.
Hey guys, I hope you liked this video. I just want to say one thing to BioWare. So BioWare, if you are listening, please reconsider and make a Femshep movie instead. I will do a FAQ commentary to this video, and the last question refers to Shepard's gender and how that influences audiences' perception in this particular scene. I have written 5 screenplays, all Femshep, so I'm really confident that Femshep movies are better in most of the scenes. There are just more unique and interesting things you could do with it, and it's totally possible to make her believable as a commander, relatable as a girl, and likable as a person, the 3 cornerstones of her characterization. If you could just email me here, I'd be so honored to have you read it. If not, that's alright, I'll just keep converting these scripts into audiovisual format, but I need some help. So if anyone's interested, click here for an upcoming recruitment video, and now the epilogue as promised.